BBN Jack Frost. What's up, party people? How's everybody doing? I'm hoping everybody's having a beautiful day. Okay, we got a lot to talk about. First thing I want to say is we are back in court tomorrow. Tomorrow we pulling back up in court. We're covering our first case since this whole shutting down of America started. We're going to be covering our first case since this whole shutting down of America started. When they shut down America, they kind of hurt us and our ability to come and bring you guys all of the things that y'all love. So, two things. One, I put absolutely no lotions on my hands. Give me 1 second. One more thing I'm going to look at real quick. Two, we got a couple of things to talk about tonight. First thing, we're going to be covering a lot of the Tackstone Troy Ave situation. We're going to be discussing that. And I also want to go over a little bit of the whole T.I. thing. Let me send something to myself real quick. I want this to come up on the jump off. I want to discuss this. My son, Ari reshared it on Instagram. My son said some things. He brought up some great points. He just brought up some great points. So I want to reshare this on. I want to discuss it with you guys. I've already reshared it on Instagram. I believe I did. Did I? I thought I did. It should be shared over there. What in the heck? Here we go. It's 4 whole minutes. I'm not gonna listen to 4 whole minutes of it. It's just too much. It's too much. It's 4 whole minutes. I don't want to do 4 whole minutes. But I guess I'll give you the gist of what he said. It's 4 whole minutes. Pull up to my son's Instagram. You get to see it for yourself. He makes a couple of good points. And I want to discuss a point specifically about it. About this whole snitching shit. I want to discuss a point specifically about this whole snitching shit that everybody talks about, because nobody, it seems like what snitching actually is has changed quite a bit. So I would like to discuss that, just so we could be clear. We're going to talk about that. I'm probably going to cover that in the beginning of the video, because the Tackstone thing is going to be a really, really long conversation, obviously. And we're not going to be on. I got to wake up early in the morning and I got to get all the way to Manhattan. So the show is not going to be a 3-hour show. It's probably not going to be a 2-hour show, most likely. We're going to get to all the points we need to get to. And then hopefully if anybody in the chat will have anything that they will want to add in, then I'm going to, you know, respond to it. Also, shout out to Jet Li. Jet Li, is you still here? Or did you just come in, leave that dope-ass comment saying, we here, and then go to the bathroom? You might have went to the bathroom. Any regard, let me go over this real quick. T.I. Boosie thing. For everybody that don't know, Boosie goes on Vlad, and I don't trust whenever Boosie goes on Vlad. Just so we could be clear, I don't trust it. I just don't trust it. I'm not saying Boosie is saying anything wrong. I'm not saying Boosie is doing anything wrong. I'm not saying Vlad is doing and or saying anything wrong. I'm just saying I don't trust it. That's it. I'm not even saying anything bad is happening. I'm just saying I don't trust it. So Boosie goes on Vlad, right? And he basically says that there is a song or an album that he was going to be doing with T.I. He dubbed the album, right? I want to say two things. One, please, you old niggas, stop doing entire albums. Unless you're a Jay-Z, unless you're a Nas, unless you're a... I'm trying to think of somebody that's like not New York-centric. But like some artists, stop doing entire albums. If you are old dude and you did an entire album and nobody cared about it, don't do another entire album. Maybe do some singles. Maybe pull up on some other dude's albums. Maybe work together like in that capacity. But with all due respect, I don't think none of us want to see an entire album of T.I. With all due respect. Would I love to see T.I. drop some verses with some other rappers? Absolutely. Please do. I don't want you to stop rapping. But I don't think anybody's checking for an entire T.I. album. T.I. is not the innovator that he once was. And now when he makes music, it's like he's just doing the new age style of whatever. The reason why I said Jay-Z and Nas specifically is they're still making Jay-Z and Nas sounding albums. So please keep making that music, because you guys aren't trying to sound like the new batch. When y'all make music, you're sounding like what you've been creating, and you're keeping that style that is your style alive. While T.I.'s not doing T.I.'s style no more. T.I.'s just making music like everybody else. He's just, you know, he's just doing what anybody else is doing. And so I'm not here for that. But, you know, other people might be. You know, do whatever you want to do. In any regard, T.I. was supposed to be doing an album with Boosie. Boosie said he backed out of it. Reason being is T.I. snitched on somebody who's passed away. And so Boosie says, and this is Boosie's point, and I want to be clear on this. I respect the Boosie's point. I'm not saying he's correct and or right. But Boosie's point is that, and this is what I think Boosie's point is. I don't know what his point actually is. That he could have gotten out of his charges. This is what I think his point is. He could have gotten out of his charges a different way. And he's just saying he's snitching on the dead nigga. So we say, okay, it's okay to snitch on the dead nigga. Now, I want to say something from me. I don't think that there's anything wrong snitching on somebody that's passed away. I don't even necessarily think it's anything wrong with putting something on somebody that passed away. Because a lot of you dudes, street dudes, y'all say, if I pass away, put the crime on me. I remember watching The Wire and watching WeeBay. And when WeeBay got caught up and he knew he wasn't never going to get out, he took everybody charges. I think he even took the murders of the niggas that was on the other side. You understand what I'm saying? So I understand that that's a street thing. So I'm not knocking nobody for doing that. I think that that's what my son's point was. That if you're trying to tell in order to hurt somebody, that's snitching. But if you're telling on a person who there's no ramifications that can reach them, then you're not doing anything wrong and you should not be called a snitch. That's just part of the game. If that's what he's saying, I kind of agree with that. I can't knock that. I can't say anything against that. If you're telling and your telling isn't necessarily putting anybody in jail, putting anybody in jeopardy, then I don't see why you can't do it. The government and the police do many things in order to get people caught up that is not legal. And they get away with it. So if there's no way for these street dudes to be able to, you know, play with their street rules, I get it. But if we're going to be doing that, then we also have to define what snitching actually is. Stop saying that civilians could be snitches. Stop saying that people walking around minding their own business, doing their own thing, that you decide to commit a crime against, is snitching. Okay? That's what I want to say. This is the main reason why I want to talk about this. It gets me upset when I hear somebody call somebody a snitch, because you are a criminal. You want to do criminal behavior to somebody who is not a part of the criminal life. And you don't think that they should have the right to call the police. That's insane. You deserve everything that you get when the police is called and they pull up on you, because that's not snitching. If that person isn't in the streets, if that person is a civilian trying to make a living, if that person is just doing regular shit, and you are being a criminal, you are doing the crimes against them, they have all the right in the world to call the police. And I think that they should. Because like I said before, like I've been saying often, the devil just wants you to fight sometimes. Because the act of fighting some of these fights is the sin. Not whether you win or whether you lose. Remember, too much pride is a sin. Envy is a sin. Jealousy is a sin. Wrath is a sin. So the devil is always trying to use those mechanisms against you to get you to step from under the protection of the Most High. So yes, please stay under the protection of the Most High. And in some cases, that means getting the protection of the police. God first. Now, with that being said, are y'all ready to talk about this? Are y'all ready to talk about this tax stone trial? Tax stone trial start tomorrow. We're going to be there. I think my shoulder's out of the socket. Like, I have a ridiculously high level of pain, a threshold for pain. So sometimes I be hurt and I really don't know it. And I be pretty badly hurt and I just don't know it. I think my shoulder's like slightly out of the socket or something. Anyway, tax stone trial starts tomorrow. It's projected to start tomorrow. We was at court on Thursday, I believe it was. Last Wednesday. We was at court last Wednesday. They said that they had to get the jurors. They were still getting the jurors together. I think they estimated when I was in court, last time I was in court, I think they had between 8 or 9 jurors already locked in. And now they're trying to find the rest of the jurors. They was going to be having another jury pool later that day. There was going to be 2 jury pools on Thursday. And then there was supposed to be some jury pools today. And then by the end of whatever today, they was prognosticating that on tomorrow, on Wednesday, that they were actually going to start the trial. That's when we're pulling up to court. Now, I want to be clear about a couple of things real quick before we even get into what we already know about the case. Earlier today, when we was talking about this particular situation, and I got some stuff to play. Earlier today, when we was talking about this particular situation, I had somebody say, how many black people were they putting on the case? I don't know what side of this you are on, but this is probably in Tax Stone's best interest for them to have as few black people on the jury as possible. Pardon me. I don't care if they're street dudes. And I don't care if they're older black people. It's probably in Tax Stone's best interest for there to be as few black people as possible on the trial. This is not white people against black people situation. This isn't a cop shot somebody, so we trying to get some black people on the jury so it could be fair. This isn't that. We got to stop looking for the racial divide and everything. Not everything has a racial divide, man. This is a trial about a black man being shot by another black man, allegedly, in a club. You're going to put black people on the stand, in the jury. Some of those black people might have lost somebody to gun violence. This is going to be against Tax Stone. Some of black people might have been, let's be honest, black people in New York City has a higher chance of being a victim or a part of some kind of gun violence than some old ass Caucasian, right? What you want to have is a jury in which you can give information to, and they're going to accept the information on the grounds that you're giving it to. You don't want to have a jury that has a predisposition to feel against your client. So for the people that's like, I hope they put black people up there in the jury, that might actually work against Tax Stone. That might not be in his favor. Okay? What happens when you got people in the jury pool and the prosecution starts using black-on-black violence or black-on-black crime as a talking point? That's going to resonate with black people more than it's going to resonate with white people. Is that really the position? So in any regard, let's be mindful that it's better to just have competent jurors than to have jurors of one color or another. The internet exists now. It's not like you can just hide information. In any regard. So let's go over one more time. Is this cool? I get pulled over a little bit more. Let's go over one time allegedly what happened, and we'll from there. I got a clip of a thing that I want to play, and then from there, I would love to, if we have anybody in here that's going to talk. We're not going to be on here all day. So if anybody want to talk, you got to speak up now, because this is not going to be a very long show. I'm looking for it there. It's not going to be a very long show. I got to wake up early tomorrow. This is not a situation where I could be late tomorrow. What up, Mr. Hassan Shipman? Salute, my brother. How you doing tonight? Yeah, this isn't gonna be a long show tonight. I gotta make sure that we up and about and we're ready tomorrow. You got business. There we go. All right, so. Two things. First, I'm going to show y'all a little bit of the clip that was sent to me with the actual.
Before I show y'all the whole video and break it down, I'm going to show y'all
how. I am not going to listen to anybody else's commentary. All due respect to that guy. I'm not trying to take away from his commentary, but we're not listening to his commentary. We just want the actual clip. Now, something I want to say real quick. There's a reason why I don't, as a content creator, come on the internet and want to get into an argument with any other content creator. I don't want to get into a pissing match. I'm not one of those guys that I want to get big because I was disrespecting somebody. So now everybody knows me for being disrespectful to the outer. I'm not here for that type of time. There's many things that we do in our culture that is just against the Most High. And so I don't really want to gravitate that way. But I get it. That's the easy way to win. I get it, but I don't want to go that way. With that being said, Tax Stone decided to take on somebody else's problem that they had with Troy Ave. For everybody that don't know, Troy Ave is a rapper that was coming out of Brooklyn. And he was speaking really spicy, like, you know, he was in the streets doing these drugs, dealing those drugs or whatever the case is. Now, we know that that's the way to get to the bag. There were people also coming out of Brooklyn also that knew Troy Ave, or they say that they knew Troy Ave, and they said that he wasn't on that type of time. All that shit was fake, right? This is what I mean by jealousy and envy. Did it matter that he was saying fake shit if he was saying fake shit? Like, did it really matter? Pardon me. Did it matter? I think that that's the part that kind of gets to me. Every time I look at where Tax Stone is at currently. Like, did it matter? Like, no disrespect to Lil Baby, but you really think Lil Baby is riding around shooting the block up? No disrespect to Gunna, but we know for a fact Gunna wasn't on that type of time. You understand? So did that really matter? That man couldn't have just made his music? Or was it that, you know, he had a certain emotion that other people wanted to steal from him? Now, I'm not saying that that's what it was. But what I'm saying is, Tax Stone shouldn't be locked up right now fighting for his life in this situation. And Benga should still be here with his family. That's what I'm saying. With all due respect. I'm not trying to disrespect nobody. If anybody takes it that way, that's on you. What I'm saying is that when we give in to certain urges, we allowing the Satan, we allowing the devil to be involved in what we doing. You see, there's a difference between a misunderstanding and somebody purposely doing you wrong. You see, when there's a misunderstanding, we could talk about it. When somebody's purposely trying to do you wrong, you can't have a conversation with them. Because they're not listening to you. They know what they did on purpose. You busy trying to get a clear understanding with them, while the whole time, their inward voice, they're laughing. Because they meant what they did. So, Taxstone gets into it with Troy Ave over the internet because of somebody else that don't, like, you know, other people was mad at Troy Ave. And that's why I try to say, when we have people pull up in the comment section, don't try to get me to beef with another YouTube content creator. I'm not doing nothing. Don't try to get into a beef with a YouTube content creator. Like, that don't even make sense. Name me a YouTube content creator that beefs with niggas online and make money. Name me one. I can name you YouTube content creators that mind their business while other people beef with them. I've heard that. Just so we could be clear. But you're not going to make money beefing. Shout out to Gotti. Salute. You're not going to make money beefing. Why are you beefing for? Are you in this to make money, or are you in this to just be arguing with niggas over nothing? So in any regard, a situation happens where finally Taxstone, Troy Ave is in the same place, and then a fight breaks out. I'm about to show y'all the clip. I've never seen the video before this morning. This morning I saw the video for the first time. I never saw the video before this morning. This morning, I saw the video for the first time. Now that's supposed to be Taxstone. Now hold on. I think I can find this. Hold on. I think I can find this guy's page online. Let me get this guy's page online so I can bring the screen up for y'all. Hold on. I'm gonna go straight to the guy's page. What's up, Tyson Garcia? He says, salute. Happy New Year, sir. Happy New Year to you, sir. I'm very happy to see you up in here today. Hope everything is going well with you and yours. Let me go find this guy's page real quick. Hold on, let me call this drop real quick. I'm gonna bring this up on the screen so we can see it. Yeah, definitely. Very happy to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. Just hope everything's going well with you and yours. We're gonna bring this up on the screen, make sure everybody can see it better. Because I know seeing it from my phone is like janky, right? Shout out to his son Shipman with the $10 drop. He says, all of the things. We got to get an all of the things shirt. I might make it tonight. I might make the design for the all of the things shirt tonight. All right, so let's pull this up on the screen. Who's next? Let's get something going tonight. Come on, let's go. Excuse me. Excuse me. Wrong button. Excuse me. Okay. Is that how it goes? That's good. That's good. All right. So we going to... Appreciate you, Dre. Shout out to Dre Williams. Because I really don't want to take this guy's commentary. I don't like being influenced by others. Give me one moment. Give me one moment. Hold on. I'm blowing out too quick. All right, so let's get to the screen. Okay, so hold on. Let's go back a little. I'm going to start going frame by frame a little. Is there a slow up button here? Is there a way to slow this up? Hold on. Quality is only at there. Could I raise this quality? Let's see if I can raise the quality on this one. Okay, so you see this dude right here with the green shirt on? Now, this is what I was told. I don't know who this is. But that's supposed to be Tax Stone right here with the white shirt. This is supposed to be Tax. Now, listen to this. Did you hear that? Now, I don't know if that's Tax Stone. Let's just be clear on this. I'm not saying that it is Tax Stone. Let's just be clear on that. But allegedly, that's supposed to be Tax Stone. Three shots. Nigga skedaddle. Tax Stone's in back of this guy. And then another shot rings out. Y'all can't hear? Hold on. Y'all can't hear? Sheesh. Hold on. I don't know why it's like that. Hold on, hold on. I don't know why it's like that. Hold on, hold on. Let me hook this up to this. Oh man, I might accidentally unplug the shit. All right, so y'all can't hear. It's just people yelling and screaming. I'll just have to tell y'all when the. I don't know why you can't hear. Hold on. I'm gonna mute my mic. I'm gonna see if you can't hear it because it's. Let me know if you can hear it. I'm going to mute my mic and see if that helps. Give me one second. There's a reason, because sometimes they got playback, whatever, right? So let me mute my mic. Tell me if you can hear. Okay, so my computer's busted, so I couldn't even see the thing that you said. I see it now. Settings and playback speed. Copy. My computer's busted. Like, that whole side of my screen, I can't even see it. Hold on. That's way too slow. Let's see what happens. All right, so that's supposed to be taxed on. Hold on. Let's go. All right, so this is whatever's going on, right? They're arguing, pushing, shoving. Stuff is happening. So who is this guy? I want to know. I thought that was taxed on initially. But what I was told was, is this right here with the white shirt? This guy is taxed on. Yeah, that's taxed on. I can see his face. I don't know who this guy is. He getting the fuck up out of there, though. Now, I heard Choyav had a hat on. So Taxstone is behind that dude, and another shot goes off. Hold on. I'm going to show y'all on my phone so you can actually hear what I mean by another shot goes off. So hold on. I'm going to show you something. Another shot goes off after Taxstone gets in back of the other guy. So I'm going to show y'all this again. I'm only showing y'all on the phone so you can hear. Now watch. Taxstone's going to go in back of the guy with the green. Now you're going to hear the gun go off again. So somebody brought up something earlier this morning. I'm not saying that's what it is. And Glass says, and Troy ain't shoot until he got out the room. So who was that shooting? Also, I'm not saying Troy was shooting. I'm saying I don't know who, which one of the people Troy was, just so we could be clear. So who was shooting? They get out of there. Who's that? They see the people on the floor right here. Taxstone, that is Taxstone, unequivocally. Behind the dude in the green. So is somebody else supposed to be on trial? Is Taxstone literally only on trial because he was out there talking smack? Taxstone might literally only be on trial because he was talking smack, and that was his gun. Pardon me. Taxstone might literally only be on trial right now because that was his gun and because he was talking crazy on the internet. Literally. Taxstone's in back of this dude now. That's him right there. And then another shot goes off. So who was shooting? Hold on. To see people on the floor. That's tax on. That's taxed on. 100%. You see the beard. You see the, not trying to make fun of him, but you see, you know, his head shape. That's taxed on, unequivocally. No gun in his hand currently. Another shot, at least one more shot goes off after this. There's also a girl screaming about how she got shot in the leg. I'm trying to get to a spot. I just pressed the button too slow twice. Glasses, Mano said what Troy Yav said didn't play out like that. I don't know what to do. What up? I mean, I don't know what to tell you. From the way I hear it, Mano isn't your biggest Troy Yav fan. I don't usually jump on board with what somebody says when I know that they don't like the person that we're discussing. Is that fair? Give me 1 second. Also, I am under the understanding that obviously not everything any party says is absolutely true. And that's why it's important, especially for a person doing what I do, to have the ability to talk to both sides. Because I don't have nothing in this fight. The only thing that really affected me is the fact that we lost somebody. Somebody died over some shit that didn't have to happen. I'm way more concerned with that than anything else. I never knew Banger. I never met him. I heard he's a good guy, whatever, you know, street nigga, whatever the case is. Give me 1 second. My issue is always, I don't really care for when we're out there causing harm to each other when it's not necessary. That's always going to be my beef. I'm always going to have an issue with that. And I'm not ever going to side with the people that are creating problems when they're not necessary. I'm just not. No, I'm not saying Mano's wrong. I'm not saying Mano is wrong, by the way. Shout out to Mano. I hear good things about that man, too. I'm not saying Mano is wrong. I'm not saying Mano is wrong. I hear good things about Mano, by the way. I'm not saying Mano is wrong. I know some people that know the guy. I hear good things about Mano. I'm not saying Mano is wrong. I don't know anybody that knows Troy Ave specifically. I've met Troy Ave. I haven't hung out with him. I don't hang out with the guy, nothing like that, but I've met him. I've spoken with him. I know two people that know Troy Ave. And I know one person I think that absolutely knows Troy Ave, but I haven't had into a conversation with people about Troy Ave before, just so we could be clear. I know people that know Mano. I know people that know my son. I know people, I used to play people basketball with people from Highbridge. I know people that know my son. Get it? I know people that know Mano. I know people that know a couple of these guys. And even some of these dudes that people think is the most, you know, even some of these dudes that are real street dudes that done some real street things, that don't mean that they don't got good hearts. Like I said before, the reason why I have the position that I do is because I know people that are good people and they had to do some real bullshit in their life because of the society that has been created for us. So I don't always judge people by whether they a street nigga or not as a negative thing, because there's a lot of good dudes out here that just happen to be street niggas. I know real killers. Real killers. I know dudes that used to chop people up and feed their body parts to dogs. I know real killers. This is no cap. I've met the dogs. Let's read some comments for a second. I'm reading comments. I'm going to drop an invite down there if anybody want to pull up and chop it up. And I just don't even like using that term no more. If anybody want to pull up and talk about it. I'm going to read some of these comments, so I'm going to put some of them up on the screen. I'm going to go over a couple already so I can respond to them in real time. Let's see what we got going over here. Troy Ave ain't shoot. Troy Ave ain't shoot until he got out the room. Exactly. So who was shooting the gun? And then they said Troy Ave chased. Allegedly, Troy Ave chased Taxstone out of the green room. But it looks like Taxstone was standing in back of the dude with the green shirt. So who was Troy Ave shooting at? I would like to know. I'm just saying. Was he did he end up seeing him? And after that, he chased him out the green room? Or was Troy Ave shooting at somebody else? I'm just saying. I'm asking. These are valuable questions to ask, by the way, if you ask me. Maybe they're not. Glass says, Mano said Troy Ave was saying... Mano said what Troy Ave saying didn't play out like that. What I'm saying is that I'm not saying Mano is not telling the truth. What up, King Jai? What I'm saying is because he has a disposition against Troy Ave, they could see the same thing, but they could witness, they could be at the same place but see different things. Right? Perspective. Right? Is that fair? What up, Darkwing? Is that fair? You could be at the same place with somebody, but due to perspective, see two different things. You ever watched a movie with your woman? And then sat there like, what? Where did you get that from? Glasses, if the defense plays this video and asks Troy Av and ask if Troy Av shot in the green room, if he says no, that's reasonable doubt. If who says no? Shout out to Sebastian Tompkins. He says, lobby boys, guys, boys in the lobbies. Darkwing says, and the reason why it's lobby boys, because that's where it get cold. That's where you gotta be at, because it's too cold to be outside. If you know, you know. He says, Darkwing says, yeah, you do. Troy Ave grew up around the corner from me. But I know more people that have actually came in contact with Troy Ave. I know a couple that just don't like him. But I never really had a real, like, you know, anyway. Hassan Shipman says, I remember the video. They had another angle that showed Troy Ave shooting the gun. The girl that got hit was with Mano. He talk about it. Also, if the girl that got hit was with Mano, or Troy says no, that's going to be reasonable doubt. If the girl that got hit was with Mano, that means she was standing next to Mano, right? Who is Troy shooting at again? Anyway, I'm not nobody's lawyer, and I'm not trying to be quiet. Obviously, they're going to have a better video than the one we just saw. I'm not nobody's lawyer. I'm not here to help nobody do shit. Hassan Shipman said they had another. I remember the video. They had another angle that showed Troy. Yeah, that's when he was walking out of the place. That's when they was walking out of the place. That's a fact. There you go. Prosecutor had evidence to charge taxes fraud. I don't think every single time somebody gets charged, they get found guilty, do they, Bruce Banner? I don't think the fact that we charge somebody for a crime means that they're guilty. Is that fair? I'm just asking, is that fair? No. That's not what I just asked you. You just brought up a whole different point. So you mean every time somebody, let's stop everything for a minute. So you mean you're guilty until proven innocent, Mr. Bruce Banner? Who do you work for? No one would ever be the case. Bruce Banner said that if they charge you, that means you're guilty. Right? That is what he just said, right? Prosecutor had evidence to charge tax. So Bruce Banner just literally said, anytime anyone gets charged with a crime, they're guilty. Right? That is what you're saying, right, Bruce Banner? He's going to say no in a minute if he responds back. I'm going to put the comment up there real quick. So Bruce Banner, you're saying that anytime anyone gets charged for a crime, they're guilty, right? No, that's not what I asked you. So you're saying, Bruce Banner, anytime anyone gets charged for a crime, they're guilty, correct? No, but you just said prosecutor had evidence to charge taxes fraud. And then after that, you said, just so we could be clear, prosecutors always do their homework before charging, right? So you don't even believe the words you're saying out of your own mouth? Why should we believe them? Because after you said these things, I asked you, did you believe the things that you just said? And you said no. So why should we believe these things that you're saying if you don't even believe them? Sebastian said, Sebastian, if you slap them in the face right now, I'll put them on a timeout. Oh, man, my arm. I don't think it's in the socket. I don't think it's all the way in the socket. I don't want to get it in there. What the hell, fam? See? So the things you're saying doesn't even hold up to your own logic. I just want to put that out there. You're saying things that don't even hold up to your own logic. These are the kind of guys that come talk to me. This is the people that come talk to me. People that don't even believe the things that come out of their own mouth. Shout out to that shit, though. I'm going to keep going, by the way, just so we can be clear on that. Shout out to Kavaskin Tompkins. He said, what did the five fingers say to the face? Hey, Bruce Banner, you're going to have to eat this time out. Not because because you're saying shit that you don't even believe, one. And two, I told him that he could pay for you to get a timeout. So we timing you out, my brother. You're going to have to sit down and think about what you was talking about before you make another damn comment. Let's keep pushing. I'm going to show some more of this video. I want to be clear on this before I show any more of the video. I want to be clear on this, right? I want this to be I want us to have a full total understanding of this. I'm not here to condemn Taxstone, and I'm not here to condemn Troy Ave. I'm not here to condemn neither one of them. If you're condemning them, fine with me, but please, I need for there to be logic connected to the things that you're saying. I need there to be logic. You understand? If you're just saying, if you can't argue your point, keep it to yourself. Or if you think you could argue your point, right? And you're trying to argue your point, but you see that your point is not making it, be like, acknowledge that. I just want you to be honest. I don't know who this person is. You got to show me your face before I put you up here. Exactly. Be honest. That's all I ask. If you got a point, I'm giving you the opportunity to express your point. If you don't have a point, don't get mad when I make you look like you don't have a point, which is probably going to make you look like you don't know what you're talking about. Because that's not my fault. Copy? Just have a point. That's all I'm asking. I don't need for it to be a great point. I'm not even asking for you to change my mind. I don't even have a mind to have one way or the other anyway. So I just want you to have a point. You was just wasting our time. And that's why Sebastian Tompkins dropped $5 so you could get a timeout. Yo, could we get some watches and get some freaking hourglasses in the chat, please? He's on timeout. Frost is a known debater. Look, I'm fair. Hold on, Sebastian. Am I not fair? I'm fair. I'm fair. Let's look at this. Who's this? That's too toy to be Troy, right? That's too tall to be Troy, right? Who's this? Troy had on a white shirt that night. I'm wondering if this is Troy. Now, this person, pay attention to this person. I'm going to show you where I see you show them again. All right, so boom, whatever's happening. That person moves. You see that person goes down a little. That person stumbles a little, right? Stuff is happening. We can't see. It went black for a second. That's Casanova in the blue. So that's definitely not Troy Ave behind Casanova. All right, so you're saying that's Cass. Shout out to Cass. Free Cass. So hold on. I got a whole different question now. I got an entirely different question. Yo, my dude, I know you was here in the morning, but if you coming up here to debate, have a point. Don't just be saying nothing and you don't got a point. You literally just said that if the prosecution charges you, that means you guilty. So we're not doing that, copy? Because guess, we're not doing that. Okay? We are not doing that, dude. You asked for that, and that's not my fault. I gave you enough time to explain yourself. Don't come up here with arguments that you don't believe. We're not talking about no New York Times article neither. What I asked was this. Listen. I asked you, stop. You're just holding up the chat at this point. You don't have to just move to a different point. You're just holding up the chat at that point, and that has absolutely nothing to do with the question that I asked. And the question that I asked is, just because you get tried, or just because they indict you, do that mean basically are you guilty? Because that's what you said. I believe that people could be indicted and not be guilty. If you call yourself a street nigga And at the same time, you trying to say everybody that gets indicted is guilty. That sounds weird. That sounds weird. So let's just move on to the next part that we're talking about. Let's not get stuck on that. Not everybody that gets indicted is guilty, homie. Just know a better way to express your thoughts. That's the best way I could put it. With all due respect. Because I don't even think you necessarily meant that. I just think that you didn't know how to express your point. And then you didn't want to concede that what you said was incorrect. All right, so this is supposed to be Casanova right here. Who's that in back of Cass? Is that Mano in back of Cass? Okay, that's when the gun went off. You see the other dude that's in back of the dude that's in back of Cass duck right when that happened. I think it's when the gunshot went off, the first one. Cass is getting the heck up out of there. And look how congested and packed that is. You can't be having guns in a place like that. Anybody, no, sheesh. And this is why you can't pull up to be beefing with niggas at clubs. Look how many people is there, yo. You can't even get away. Now look, that's Taxstone. He pulled up in back of dude with the green. Ducking. Nowhere to go. This is one of those situations where only the big strong niggas is gonna be able to get out the room because everybody pushing and shoving. Oh, Cass had a black shirt on, so that's not Cass. Who's the dude with the blue? There's another video. Send it to me. Okay, so you're saying that's not Casanova. So I'm going to say what I wanted to say. I didn't want to really say too much because I don't know if that's Cass or not. But this is what I want to say. I don't know who that is. But check this. I'm going to show this real quick. Whatever the hell was going on with Taxstone and Troy Ave and them is happening right then. Mm-hmm. Copy. I'm going to check it right now. Hold on. Whatever's going on with Taxstone and Troy Ave is happening right then. Now, it's happening right now. Whatever's going on with Tax and Troy is happening right now. So who are these guys standing there watching? Oh, my fault. I turned on my phone, Instagram, and somebody was cooking. Some chick was cooking food. Shout out to K Goddess. So she's grilling some food, and I just like to watch food being cooked. I like to prepare food. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. Which one was the one you just sent? I don't know which one is the one you just sent. You just sent one right now, right? Is that the one with Trife talking? No, you talking about the one with Trife talking? All right, we'll play it. No, you're not talking about that one? Okay, so I'm seeing the one you just said you sent. Send it. Here we go. I see. Hold on. I got it now. You know what minute mark I want to go to? Tell me what minute mark to go to. I didn't see a show. You got to tell me where to go to. I just see a show. Tell me where to go to. Give me 1 second. 2:30? All right, so we're going to put it up on the screen. Give me 2 seconds. We're going to put it up on the screen. Give me 1 second. Let me see what the name of this is real quick. Okay, so what are we looking at? Everybody's already cleared out. Is that after? What are we looking for? Tell me what we're looking for. Nah, they go Cass right there with the black shirt on. I was definitely not Cass in the blue shirt. I thought the dude looked too small. Hey, I know that guy. What the heck, yo? Shout out to John John TV. What am I looking for? What are we looking for? Here go T.I. I'm gonna speed it back up, but I don't want to get the volume. Volume's off. Like, what are we looking for? Tell me what we looking for. I'm gonna put it back to 130 something. Tell me what we looking for. He might just look like somebody I know. Tell me what we looking for. That's the room they were in, I'm supposing. I know for a fact. I'm supposing. Let me just say that. The Uncle Murder? Casanova just had on a black shirt. He had a black shirt on. That first, that blue shirt guy was not Casanova. Casanova had on a black shirt, black tee. No hat. These guys roll with everybody in the world except for people that know how to deal with nothing, just nothing. That's the dude right there. Hold on. I'm going to stop it. That's the dude right there that was standing that I was like, who is that? That's him. He was standing right over there when the shit jumped off with Tax. Yeah, that's Uncle Murder right there with the blue hat on and the white shirt. I'm going to say why I said this is something. That's Uncle Murder, right? Listen to what I'm about to say in 2 seconds. He was standing there. That's Uncle Murder, right? Hold on. Shoot, I should have kept the other jump off up. Right? So hold on. I'm gonna dub this. I'm gonna drop this for 1 second so I could go get the other so I could put them back to back with each other, right? So hold on. So you can see what I'm saying. Shoot, wrong button. What's my history? Page. Home, not that. Members, community. The fuck is my history? They don't show you the history on this bitch? Do it on the phone. All right, so hold on. So what was the name of that other video? Hold on, I'm gonna show you something. Listen to what I'm about to say. I'm not saying I'm right about nothing. But I just want to just bring up a point real quick. Why I'm the way I am. And why I don't believe none of these niggas. Niggas is always super tough when they got people behind them. Or when they think they got you jammed up or boxed in. That's when niggas is tough. Niggas don't be tough in other situations. Niggas do not be tough unless they think they got you jammed up and boxed in. Y'all be respecting that type of shit. And I just don't. What the heck, yo? I be respecting that. I just don't. I be respecting when niggas jump niggas. I be respecting when niggas box niggas in so they can have the advantage. Y'all just be respecting shit that I just don't respect. I just don't respect it. And I don't care that. I don't care what anybody got to say about that. I just don't respect it. I think one of the main reasons why I don't respect it is because I'm always have groups of people coming after me. You understand what I'm saying? So I just don't respect that. I'm sorry. So I want to show y'all something real quick. Now, I'm not questioning nobody's manhood, and I'm not coming for nobody. Right? I'm not questioning nobody's manhood, and I'm not coming for nobody. I'm not questioning nobody's manhood, and I'm not coming for nobody. I just want to be clear about something real quick. Now, let's talk about all the people who allegedly don't like Tax, don't like Troy Ave, right? It was, right? All the people that allegedly don't like Troy Ave, right? Now, with all due respect, this room that they was in had a lot of people in it that was pro-tax, right? That was taxes people, right? That guy right there is that guy right here, right? Who's he standing next to? He's standing right in back of who? Right? All due respect. I'm not coming for nobody. I'm just pointing out facts. Who's that? Who's that? Who's that? That's tax man, right? Am I wrong? Am I wrong? I'm asking, am I wrong? You can't get jumped if you with your peoples, yo. You can't get jumped if you with your peoples. This ain't grade school. This ain't elementary school. This ain't junior high school, homie. You can't get jumped if we all high school and up. If you with your peoples, you cannot get jumped, homie. Remember, we all go home and none of us go home. Am I lying? Am I lying? We all go home and none of us go home. Am I lying? If I'm wrong, let me know I'm wrong. If I got a point, drop a frost in the chat. You can't get jumped if you with your peoples, homie. Because if you with your peoples, it's a fight. You cannot get jumped if you with your peoples. What y'all talking about? I don't want to hear that he got jumped no more. I don't want to hear he got jumped. He didn't get jumped. His people was there. They just didn't get in. That's not getting jumped, my nigga. That ain't getting jumped. Getting jumped is when you alone. When your peoples is there, that's not getting jumped. Please call it the right thing with all due respect. Hold on, just so we can understand my position real quick. Call it the right thing with all due respect. With all due respect, hold on. So, hold on. So, Uncle Murder ain't his people? Uncle Murder ain't Cass people? Put me on the game. I'll acknowledge, maybe I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Maybe I think Uncle Murder is Cass people, but he ain't. So, Uncle Murder is not Cass people. Uncle Murder is not tax people, pardon me. So none of those dudes that we just saw is tax people. Tax Stone. I know what I'm talking about, Bruce. So Uncle Murder is not taxed on people? Stop sending me to go listen to shit. I'm just asking, because maybe I don't know. Because I thought that was his people. Troy Ave thought that was his people. So why did Troy Ave think that was his people? Is there an answer? Because if Troy Ave thought that that was his people, then once again, that's not jump. You get it? Do you understand what I'm trying to explain? So Tax was there all by himself. Copy. So that's not, okay, that's not Uncle Murder's people. Uncle Murder even said it in the rap, is what you're saying. Why ain't you help him? I ain't come with that nigga. We ain't cool like that. But it's free tax, nigga. We don't wish jail on a nigga. Free tax, nigga. Rest in peace, Combat Jack. Damn, that nigga was really in there by himself. So why the hell was Troy Ave talking about that he ain't help him? Tax wasn't, so Cass was not in the room. That probably wouldn't have went down like that if Cass was in the room, not for nothing. So Casanova was not in the room at all. Because I don't think it would have went down like that if Cass was in the room. That's why I was like, is that blue shirt Casanova? That blue shirt is not Casanova. All right. Like I said, who was Troy Ave shooting at? Didn't I say that this morning? I said that this morning, right? Didn't I ask you that this morning? Who was Troy Ave shooting at? Did I say that this morning or did I say that this night? Who was Troy Ave shooting at? For everybody that's wondering why I'm saying who was Troy Ave shooting at, I'll show you. Taxstone was behind this dude right here with the green. Then see dude in the blue duck out. Shots is going off. Niggas is pushing, shoving. Casanova gonna duck behind this dude with the green. So that means that Casanova wasn't running out the building. Did Casanova run out after this? You're gonna see Casanova head pop up over here in a second. This is Casanova ducking behind dude in the green. I mean, Tax Stone, pardon me. Duck behind dude in the green. So who was Troy shooting at? Oh, I put the screen down. Appreciate you. Tell him, let me know. Boom. So here goes Casanova. Tax Stone duck behind the dude in the green. So who was Troy shooting at? You're going to see him pull up. He's going to duck behind the dude in the green. Give him 2 seconds. So who's Troy shooting at? So who's Troy shooting at? Hold on, I'm gonna duck this for 1 second while I go get something else. And shout out to the people that don't believe all of the bullshit that people say about me that ain't true. Shout out to y'all. I appreciate y'all. What am I looking for? Who's he shooting at? He got shot in both his legs, too. So who's he shooting at? No, this is not a federal case currently. This is in regular criminal court. And I don't care about that. That isn't part of our discussion currently. Anyway, court starts in the morning. We're going to be there. About to sneeze and burp at the same time, whatever the hell. Yes, they're definitely closely monitoring this case. You better believe it. I think the Fed case was the gun charge, right? Because that was over in the state. That was intrastate, right? I was going from one state to another. So I believe the Fed case was the gun charge. Right? I got a question. Do we even got one female in this community left, or have all of the females left because of the people that lie on me and backdoor hit y'all up on Instagram or anywhere else that they could find? That's not going to work, by the way. But I'm just curious. How he's going to be released on time served? He had to still serve time for the gun charge. How long he been in jail? How much time did they give him for the gun charge? Oh, wow. He's been in jail for a minute. How much time did they give him for the gun charge? So he really need to beat this. Anyway, we're going to be at court in the morning. I'm going to wrap it up because I got to get up early. The heck is this? No. Is this chick really 5'10"? I mean, 6'5", like 6'5" or some shit? Like, is she really 6'5"? I'm just so curious. I don't believe she's 6'5". I mean, she's kind of tall to that door. That's a mirror. I don't believe she's 6'5". No, she's not 6'5". She's just capping. All right. Sorry about that. So you're right. He might be getting out if he could beat this. So we're going to see what happens. We're going to pull up in court tomorrow. I'm going to let y'all go so I can make sure that I'm up bright and early. I got to get out of here early. I live all the way at the end of Brooklyn. So everywhere to go is like, sheesh. So I got so I got to get out of here early. So we're going to get off of the live now. Everybody, please have a good night. I'm going to cover the case as best as we can. Depending on when court actually opens up and what time I actually get down there, I might go live earlier than actual court. All right, just so we can be clear. I might go live earlier than actual court. We'll see. I'm going to do the best job that I can, as always. I'm going to finally, we're going to most likely know what type of case the prosecution plans on putting on, and opening statements from the prosecution and the defense. I'll be able to break those down. And then I'll be able to answer some of these questions that people come here and ask me about. And then I'll be like, how can I know that? Like, all they did was talk to, like, what the heck are you talking about? The other day I had somebody come in here and say, what do you think the prosecution is going to use as their defense or whatever? And I'm like, I don't know currently. I don't know what kind of defense the prosecution is going to put up. First of all, if I don't know what kind of case if I don't know what kind of case the prosecution is going to put on, and somebody asks me, what do I think the defense is going to do? How can I tell you what the defense is going to do? I don't know what kind of case the prosecution is going to put on. I think the best thing you could always do is try to attack the prosecution's points, not necessarily just try to have your own narrative. And I think that that's how a lot of times people get convicted. They'll go talk to their lawyer. The best case and example is what just happened with Tory Lanez. They'll go talk with their lawyer, and instead of them trying to take apart the prosecution's case, what they'll try to do is, no, listen to what I'm saying. Listen to what I'm saying. When in reality, you should be saying, look, the thing that they're saying doesn't make any sense. So, like, when people come in here and they try to say some weirdo shit, and I'm like, it will explain your point, and then they can't explain their point, and then I explain how their point don't make any sense. Like, that's how you're supposed to handle the shit in court. If you go to court and you try to put up some of these arguments that I be seeing people put up online, like, you're going to lose. I'm sorry. These arguments that people be putting up online, you're going to lose. Like, 99% of the time. Like, you understand? Like, you see what they're trying to do down there with trying to bring Drake involved in that XXXTentacion situation. Like, this is real life. This isn't the internet. The courts is real life. And on top of that, a lot of people don't even understand how laws actually work. So you don't even know how laws are applied. You understand? So you're busy trying to go in there saying, yo, they should say this, they should say that. You're supposed to take apart the prosecution's case, period, end of story. What's this guy's name? The dude involved with Megan Thee Stallion situation. Tory Lanez, they went and tried to just, this is why we're innocent. And you see what happened to him. Now imagine me trying to tell you what the prosecution should do, what the defense should do, and I don't even know what the prosecution is doing. That don't make sense. So we're going to know what somebody said, because you was in court. I was in court while they were choosing jurors. They're not putting on their case while they're choosing jurors, by the way. So we're going to show up to court tomorrow. Tomorrow is when the case should start. And they will have a better understanding after opening statements about what the prosecution is trying to do and what the defense is trying to do. I don't even know if the defense should open with their opening statement initially. Maybe they should. I don't know. But maybe they shouldn't. Maybe they should wait until they put their case on to do their opening statement. Generally speaking, I think that usually helps the defense sometimes to hold their opening statement back until it's their turn to call their witnesses. So we'll see what happens. Prosecution is going to say what they're going after. But from what I saw on the video, without a shadow of a doubt, Tax Stone maybe when Troy Ave, you know, those shots that we hear being shot after Tack Stone is in back of the dude with the green shirt, maybe that's when Troy Ave is outside. Who is he shooting at? I don't know. Do you know? With that being said, everybody have a beautiful night. And remember, if you got anybody still awake in your household, give them a hug. Tell them you love them. You don't never know what's going to happen tomorrow. Give people the flowers while they're still here. Also, after we wake up and before we go to bed, glass of water, nutrients, empty stomach. And whenever we're helping somebody else be the best them that they can be, in that moment, we'll be in the best us that we could be. So go out there and be great. Like, comment, subscribe. Join the notification game. Hashtag Bronx Bombers. Let's get it. I love y'all. Take care of each other. Hug the kids for me. I haven't forgotten about you. And that's all I got on this one.